Hey guys, Denfish from girlschase.com. What we're going to be talking about today is why you should never hook up with your ex. All right, now I've been the worst about this, about falling back in with exes, having sex with them again. I did this a lot when I was a lot younger. And I did this from a place of actually scarcity when I think back on it. I just have scarcity not knowing that somewhere down the line another girl would come along. Now, if you're watching this video, there's a good chance that you're thinking of hooking up with your ex. In this video, I'm gonna tell you why it's god-awful to get back in a relationship with your ex, why it's even terrible to have a sex with your ex. Now, me personally, I grow pretty fast. I am a quickly evolving person, and a lot of times when I'm with a girl, I usually evolve past her and I get to the point where she's lower thinking in terms of maybe abundance, maybe in positivity, maybe in life, not wanting as much for herself. So for me, I almost end up having to peel off girls off of me nowadays. I am still pretty young, so it makes sense. However, I have made a lot of mistakes. I've made a lot of stupid mistakes in getting back with exes and having sex with exes. All right, so why is this a bad thing? Why is it bad to have sex with an ex? Now, me personally, every time I have sex with an ex, usually it means that we get back together, or it means more emotional trauma for me in the end. Now me, if I date you, it's because I like you. It's because more than likely I love you, and if we break up, it's pretty hard on me to go back to the relationship or go back and have sex with you and then you leave and then maybe you go date some other dude or something like that. It's just honestly really tough on a person to have to deal with that kind of shit. If you're the kind of person that goes back to an ex, has sex with her, then is emotionally traumatized because, you know, off, and then it just buries up old wounds and it makes it a lot harder for you to get over the relationship. It makes it a lot harder for you to get over her because she keeps coming back into the picture and you keep fantasizing about getting back together with her, which is fucking things up for you. Now, you cannot get back together with an ex. It is almost impossible. Now, the reason being is because when you break up, there's a lot of resentment. There's a lot of bad things. There's a lot of unearthed stuff, maybe things throughout the relationship that has built animosity between you two. And if you guys get back together, it's not going away. If you guys come back together and start talking again, the animosity is not going away. It's always gonna be there. It takes a long time for that kind of stuff to get buried, for people to not feel so hurt over the things you've done to them, and maybe vice versa. So let's say maybe she cheated on you and you sleep with her, the wounds come right back. You remember how she cheated on you, you remember the pain, and it comes right back, and it makes it harder for you to get over her. It makes it tough for her to get over you. It makes it tough for you guys to move on with the relationship, find new people. Now remember, you guys broke up for a reason, and it's not going away. To be honest, you guys being in touch with each other and keeping contact, if you're an emotional person, it's a bad decision, because it's gonna keep bringing up the pain and keep bringing it back. It's gonna make it harder for you to heal, because every time you go back together with her, it reopens the wound, you're really hurt again. It's like throwing salt in the wound, it's fucking you up. Now I get it, there's the emotional attachment to this girl. There's that extra little bite to her, almost like that feeling, because you've been with her for so long, your mind is gonna try to play tricks on you to get you back together with them, because it doesn't know you're in today's society, where there's 8 billion people on this planet. There's 8 billion people here, half of those people are women. Now your brain's gonna try to tell you there's nobody else for you but her. It's gonna try to play tricks on you because it wants you to get back together with her, because it doesn't know this about the world. It doesn't know how much abundance there is in women. Now, firstly, you need to understand that and detach yourself from it. Detach yourself from it. Understand your brain's trying to play tricks on you. If you're feeling bad, you're feeling angry, you're feeling sad, fuck it. Just understand and detach from it. If better yet, actually turn it into a positive thing. Make that energy positive for you, because now you have this energy that's gonna drive you to do something else. Maybe go find another person, maybe change yourself for the better, things like that. You need to be in abundance. You need to understand there's a lot of women out there, and there's another girl out there for you that's even better. Good is the killer of great. All right, if you're in a good relationship, go find a great relationship. All right, that's something that you guys need to start looking for yourselves. Do not keep falling back into previous habits, because if you keep going back to an ex, it's gonna keep bringing you back to that old person you used to be and won't give you a chance to change. It's not gonna give you a chance to grow and maybe find somebody even better for you than the previous one was. If you're having a hard time saying, you know, no to having sex with her, this is what I say. Instead, baby step it. So if she texts you up one day, says, hey, you wanna hang out? Baby step it. Wait it out an hour, 2 hours, maybe wait it out a little bit longer. Maybe tell her, hey, yeah, let me see what's going on later tonight. Keep postponing it. Now, see, what's happening is that you're not burning as much willpower by saying outright no, all right? Instead, you're being like, oh no, let me think about it. Oh no, this, oh no, that. And then as time goes on, it slowly dissipates. It gets easier and easier to say no, because as time went on, you're not burning as much willpower to just say later. Oh no, later, oh no, later. And eventually, you know, she's gonna get the point that you're saying no. It's gonna be easier for you than, you know, giving in and having sex. So ultimately you're having a hard time with this, do this job, do this rule, because this helped me out a lot and helped me out with stopping myself from doing stupid shit. Now, another really cool trick that helped me out was start reframing things. So you were in the mindset of a boyfriend, right? You still have that personality. You're like, oh no, I'm the boyfriend type of guy. No, no, fuck that. What you're gonna do now is, now you're the single guy. Now you're the player. Now you're the bachelor. Now you're the guy that all girls chase. Start telling yourself these stories, because what's gonna happen is it's gonna start manifesting. Instead of you waiting and you being sad and you being depressed about being single, instead, now you're gonna make it an empowerment. Instead, you're gonna empower yourself to take control of your situation and not be a victim of it. If you guys are looking to help out your life, help out your relationships, help out your social skills, Girls Chase does have a product for you. There's a 7-day free course, absolutely free. It's in the description below, check it out. All right guys, pretty much all I wanna say about this video. If you guys truly wanna get good at this, like I said in the beginning of the video, Girls Chase 7-day product, absolutely free in the bottom. And if you guys wanna follow me further, my Instagram is TheLoveHitchhiker and my Facebook is Denton Fisher. And with that being said, peace out. Bye.